Hi, Jim Romer from Weather Wealth, advising farmers and traders for 38 years. Look at this flooding in Australia. Unbelievable. It's affecting a lot of crops, but the wheat market hasn't reacted. We'll talk about that today in today's report. These are the winds causing the negative Indian dipole, we call it. Look at the blue, the cool ocean temperatures near Africa, and the red, the warmer ocean temperatures near Australia, creating a west to east wind, and that is a negative Indian dipole. There it is again. See the cool ocean temperatures blue? Winds tend to blow from cool to warm waters in a negative Indian dipole. Think about sitting at the beach, for example, right? You get that sea breeze off the ocean when you're on that nice hot sand. Same thing in the oceans around continents like Australia. The winds blow west to east. That's the negative Indian dipole. A better picture of that here is shaded in red. The warm ocean temperatures absorb and attract that moisture, and that's creating an unbelievable situation right now. Look at this, kangaroos, for God's sakes, jumping in water, being rescued throughout much of eastern Australia. Typically, when you see a situation like this, you have a rally in the wheat or grain market. Think of 1993, when I lived in Iowa, advising farmers, working for a company called Freeze Notice Weather in Des Moines many, many years ago. My goodness, flooding and a major rally in 1993 in soybeans and corn crops created a major spike, which doesn't happen very often from a wet weather situation during planting and the summer grain markets. 1993, this is as bad as in Australia. So why have wheat prices not reacted? Well, the recent shutdowns in China being the biggest importer of wheat, not buying as much right now. The record crops in Russia and also in Canada. There's enough supply currently, and also the stronger dollar. So if this wet weather continues, we may begin to see Australian wheat prices rally here, as I see really no end in sight from the wet weather. But right now, there are a lot of outside factors. If this drought continues in the plains next spring and we have other weather problems around the world, then we can have a bull market in grains. But right now, a lot of things are happening also geopolitically with the situation with Russia and Ukraine, and the export corridor from Ukraine being opened up once again. This is another reason why we've had a recent bear market in the grain market. Thank you. Make sure you subscribe to my YouTube channel. And if you want the best weather information, doing this for 38 years, long-range forecasts, helping farmers and traders, option strategies, ahead of the crowd, please go to my website and try to check out one of my newsletters. Some of them are actually for free as far as demoing them for a month or two. Thank you.